of the Grand Council of Haven City. For heinous acts and crimes against the people, you are hereby banished to the wasteland for life.
This is a death sentence, Vigor. There must be another way.
Your protest was overruled. This dark eco freak is dangerous. Now drop the cargo!
This is an outrage! I am outraged beyond words! Although I do have something to say. Not everyone agrees with this ridiculous decree.
Yeah, we want a recount.
Oh, I see you wish to join him.
Actually, we are not that outraged. Farewell, Jack. Stay out of the sun. Drink lots of water, if you can find it.
Jack?
Go back to the city, Dax.
I'm sorry. The council is too powerful. There was nothing
I know.
You just stay alive, you hear me? That's an order. Someone will find you. I promise.
May the precursors have mercy on you.
Daxter!
Don't thank me. I'm only here because you wouldn't last a second without me. Okay, tough guy. You got us into this mess. Now you gotta get us out.
Ah, what a team we'll make.
Let's just get moving. But which way?
That way!
That way!
Oh, and I suppose you know where you're going, huh?
Better than you do, bent beak.
Let's just move.
This was all your stupid idea.
No, it was yours. Only a bird brain could have thought this one up. Let's go with him. We'll help together. You mean we'll die together?
I can't believe the city hates us.
We saved those lowlifes.
Jack, the city's divided. Reports say new Crimson Death bots are holding a vital section of the industrial area. My men are getting their asses kicked. The KG have a new leader. We're trying to find out who it is.
I'm afraid I've got more bad news. A large group of surviving metalheads have concentrated in another section of the city.
But we destroyed Kor.
It appears the strongest metalheads have survived. The battle for the city has just begun.
The people are blaming you, Jack.
Right. Good plan, Jack. A nap would be nice. Just a teensy little rest.
This bird is overcooked.
The bells.
Report!
It's bad. The city's become a battlefield. Mechanized death bots have taken the industrial section, and the surviving metalheads have expanded their hold on the west side. We're losing ground on all fronts.
The council's meeting tonight in emergency session. Rumblings about you, Jack. It doesn't look good. They think your friendship with Krew helped the metalheads get into the city.
You don't believe that, do you?
What's in the past is done. Right now, metalheads are assaulting the palace. They're looking for something, and I have no idea.
Looks like we found some live ones. Barely. Here's the beacon we were picking up. Who gave you this? We'll take them with us. Let's move. I smell a storm coming. We're ready to pray for you. I am Damas, King of Spargus.
Spargus? Wait, Nobody lives outside Haven's walls. Not a whole city.
Ah, yes. We are the Forgotten Ones. Haven City's refuse, thrown out and left to die. Just as you were. But now that you have been saved, your life belongs to the people of Spargus. And we will use it well, if it's actually worth anything.
Hey, that sounds like a bad deal.
You are in no position to deal. Out here, everything is either useful or dead weight. Prove yourselves worthy, or the desert will be your grave.
You need to work on making a better first impression.
In the unforgiving wasteland, we value strength and survival above all. We will see where you stand soon enough. Complete your training, then enter the arena. Just the bravest crawl out and are allowed to stay in Spargus. It's quite simple, really.
What happens to the ones that don't crawl out?
Then it will be as if we never found you.
I was afraid of that.
Hail, all citizens of Spargus! Welcome to the Arena of Death, where we get to watch other people wet themselves in pee. These halls will once again test two newcomers, each fighting to prove their worth to stay among us! Let's hear it for Jack and his obnoxious talking animal!
Pecker, there you are. Where were you?
Damas says I am to be his new counselor. He says my wisdom will serve him well. Oh yeah, and Damas also says that you two are likely to die in the arena today. And he hopes your death is very...
Will you stop that? Damas can talk for himself.
He is right. You will most likely die. And yes, Pecker is my new advisor.
Unlike you, some people appreciate my talents.
It beats working for a living. I saw a few of the fights earlier. Ooh, not a pretty sight.
Why, you little...
Let the games begin!
This is the game of Jack 3, which takes place about 1 year after the events of Jack 2. In Jack 2, Jack and Daxter save Haven City from invading Metalhead armies led by Metal Kor. Not long after the destruction of Kor, Haven City is at war again. The strongest of the Metalheads had survived and teamed up with Crimson Guard Deathbots led by an unknown foe to continue to devastate the city. The people of Haven City blame Jack for his friendship with Krew and believe that the war is largely to blame on him. Corrupt Haven City official Count Vigu exiles Jack to the wasteland with the people's approval. Daxter and Pecker choose to join Jack in the wasteland. They wander the desert until they are saved by Damas, the king of the refugee city of Spargus. Jack Daxter's safety is not guaranteed. They must prove they are useful to the city of Spargus, or the desert shall be their grave. Pecker, however, has been made advisor to Damas. Here Jack is, completing this little obstacle course. I could do this a lot faster, but I'm scared I'm gonna fall into the lava. I'm not a speedrunner, I'm not trying to show off. I'm just trying to finish the mission.
The candidates have won the challenge.
That's right, we bid! You haven't forgotten what I taught you, Jack.
Anyone can make a few measly jumps. Now let's see how you rate against the living. Readjust the matter focus. Prepare the arena for full combat.
Prepare the arena for full combat.
I just said that.
I know, I was just adding, you know, how you do the thing with the... Anyway, prepare the warriors.
You mean we have to fight against actual people? With actual weapons? Who actually wanna hurt us?
Fine, bring them on.
All right, that's it. I wanna be on his shoulder.
Jack 3 has the four basic weapons of Jack 2, the Scatter Gun, the Blaster Mod, the Vulcan Fury, and the Peacemaker, but with many more upgrades and powerful attachments to make gameplay different from that of the previous game. The scatter gun here, for example, will get a grenade launcher-like attachment. I do wish that the game developers would give us completely new guns, or maybe even some axes, some melee weapons like these Marauders over here are carrying. The Marauders are desert bandits that constantly threaten the city of Spargus. They've been captured and made to build this arena. They're pretty weak. I'm taking a lot of damage. Oh, dang. I'm almost dead. I really need to be careful now. One more hit and I'm dead. Okay, there we go. Come on. Okay, I'm safe. I'm trying to turn off my dark jacket. I guess I'm not allowed to do that yet.
Something you're not telling us, animal man?
He has been touched with dark eco, my liege.
Our boy here gets all mean and nasty when you piss him off. So don't piss him off. Word to the wise.
Ah, then he is dangerous, and that could be useful. Your bravery has earned you your first battle amulet. If you are victorious in 2 more arena fights, you will earn your citizenship to Spargus. Here is a gate pass to allow free passage in and out of the city. But beware, there is no true refuge outside our walls. The desert is less kind than I. And for your victory, a gun mod is your prize.
Oh yeah, now we're talking! Hey, what do I get? Nothing, as usual.
In my previous playthrough, I didn't collect precursor orbs, but this one I will. I'm gonna collect as many precursor orbs as I can. Damas' throne over here. There are 3 precursor orbs. I'm gonna collect them. There's one over here. Just break these guards. Another one over here. And another precursor orb right there. Secrets are somewhat like cheats. I'm not sure what else to call them. The secrets would be the equivalent to a cheat in any other game.
Choke, and you would have popped, eh?
You talking to me?
Yeah, you talking to him?
No, I'm conversing with me sweet departed mom. Of course you borehead. You two are from the Big Smoke, eh?
Who's asking?
The guy who runs this place, that's who. Kleiver's the name. You blokes stick with me, and I'll take care of you. In fact, I've got a job for you right now. Ride me Leaper Lizard here and catch a few of those little buggers that have been raiding me storerooms. Snag me 6 of them puppies, and I'll let you drive one of me racing vehicles. That is, if Damas ever lets you leave the city.
I think we can handle that.
No! I hate riding animals! They make me chafe. We have to find those kangarats!
Alright, there's another precursor orb over here. To the left of the stairs, inside this little container. And another one to the right.
Keep looking!
This character, Kleiver, is going to be a pretty useful guy.
There's one of those.
He's going to give us access to the desert.
You got it.
We can use his vehicles to collect rare artifacts in the desert. We're gonna do some tasks outside the desert to gain our citizenship to Spargus. This mission is a bit tedious.
I see another one! So close!
The thing is about the citizens of Spargus is that they actually fight back, unlike the citizens of Haven City. Even if you hit them by accident, they'll still try to kill you. Now we're going to see this monk, the one who is staring at Jack in the arena.
Dudes, huh? Nice threads. I didn't know rubber was back in. What are you working on, monk boy?
It is none of your concern, animal.
Look, coloring book, we've had a hard week. Don't push it.
The arena shows all, Dark One. Hate consumes your eyes.
Great. Thanks for the tip.
It will destroy you, just as these precursors destroyed themselves.
It doesn't look like any precursor crap we've seen.
These artifacts are an abomination. One fell on the great volcano. We sent an expedition to the mountain, but my monks never returned. Ill tidings sing in the wind. I fear the remaking of the world is at hand.
I think you've been out in the sun a little too long. Let's go, Jack.
You must leave this place. Heroes think they can save the world when they themselves are lost. You could not possibly understand the dark forces at work here.
Don't talk to me about dark power.
Can't say much about this. I want to know what this is. I think it's a little tedious. Stand back. All.
Jack?
Don't touch it. Dark eco.
Yeah, you're impressed now, aren't you? Man, didn't miss preps.
Those are solid eco crystals. It has been passed down through time that they power the greatest of precursor technologies. Strange. It speaks an ancient dialect, the earliest precursor forms. Something about reclaiming this unfinished world.
Those look like coordinates. Like the ones from...
It is picking up a very powerful signal.
I don't think we're gonna like what this thing is yapping to!
Even you cannot save us from this, hero.
Hey, I'm the real hero here. You can call me Orange Lady.
Alright, now we're gonna see Kleiver. We're gonna see his garage.
But we have plans to
full of dune buggies. Vehicles that we're gonna need to explore the desert, collect artifacts, and get our citizenship to Spargus City. There's a precursor war between these two palm trees. I don't think there's any more. I'm just gonna check just in case.
Isn't the newbies.
Keep yapping, Jelly Boy. We'll see who...
Bite your bum, rat face, or I'll pound you.
Oh, great stink of the precursors. I got two words for you. Toothbrush.
Nice rides.
You like what you see?
We use these babies to make runs into the deep desert to retrieve artifacts. Tough wheels for tough work.
You said we could use one.
I did, didn't I? But not one of those. Those are for the big boys. You can use that one.
What a runt!
Seems to fit you.
Get in, Dax. I'll drive.
Can't wager a little something on a race, then? If you win, I'll let you keep that little vehicle for as long as you live. And if I win?
I don't have anything.
I'd say that yappy rodent of yours is a bit bony, but skinned and butted, he'd make a nice treat. My vehicle against him.
Forget it, buddy. Jack would never...
Done. What? Don't worry. If there's one thing I can do, it's race.
This vehicle is so small. I'm wondering how can Kleiver's big dune buggy race against this little thing? He's clearly going to win. I mean, this tiny vehicle should be very slow compared to those large dune buggies. I guess driving is not my thing. Keep on crashing. Wow. I think this car has the best controls of all the dune buggies. You can actually make a 180 degree angle or 90 degree angle with this thing. The other dune buggies are hard to steer. Not like this one. Enemies never collect the jet boosters, so shouldn't be that hard to win this race. Some of the jet boosters are pretty hard to get. See if I can get this jet boost over here. Can't get that one either. See, a lot of these jet boosters are actually pretty hard to get. This is probably the only jet booster I can collect. Catching up. Let's see if I can get it. No, I can't. At least I messed up the guy behind me. That did something. Oh yes, finally, I got it. crash. This race is almost over. I gotta pass the first guy. Need to be careful. Come on. Okay, good. Now I just have to keep my lead. It's going to be a close one. They have cars too. They're gonna constantly harass me whenever I go out of the city.
Nice wheel work. My advisor here says you have vehicle skills.
I can own my own. This one will be of use to us, Damas. I think you should keep him for now.
Can it, Pecker?
There are a number of artifacts to be found in the wasteland. Fresh storms churn the sand and reveal items that have been buried for centuries. Take the vehicle and find as many items as you can before the storms come again. And one more thing. If you get caught in the storms, they will tear the flesh from your very bones.
Ooh, great. Thanks for the pep talk.
These missions I hate the most. They're the most boring. Just driving around the desert, collecting floating artifacts that appear under the spotlight. It's tedious. They're not hard, it's just the most uninteresting. Right now we can't fight back, but soon enough we're gonna get a vehicle that has guns. We'll finally fight back against these marauders constantly harassing me. Notice they have spikes near their tires. I could probably pop my tire to get closer. You'll never get lost because whenever you need to go back to Spargus, you can just look for that tower with that light.
Head for the city, Jack! The storm's getting worse! It's getting hot!
close.
Oh, are you beginning to care? Damas says...
My concern was for the artifacts, and we will use them well. That armor you found, it is very rare indeed. Pecker here says it's the very armor Mar once wore in his battles for this planet long ago. Keep it for yourself. Trust me, you'll need it.
The more armor we get, the more health we get. Look at our health bar, we have more circles in it. So this piece of armor we collected.
You are still here?
Yeah, we thought we'd hang out, catch some rays.
This isn't a game. I am Seam. We monks are sworn to discover and protect the secrets of the precursors. These leaper mounts allow us to travel where you cannot.
Man, those babies sure stuffed their faces. We saw one gulp a load of Kanga rats not too long ago. Stupid rats! They just sat.
You will never last out here. That dark eco crystal from the satellite. I want it before it falls into the wrong hands. I'll wager a light crystal against it if you race my monks on their leapers. Sien Komtava. Barush, Barush.
Just show us where the starting line is. Your monk, get set, ride! Move aside, domehead!
What I really hate about this mission is the fact that if you even touch the opponent, you get knocked back. I hit them, I get knocked back, but if they hit me, I get knocked back. It's ridiculous. It's fine if a game wants to challenge, that's what makes a game fun, but if it's unreasonable, it's just stupid. This isn't a hard mission though.
So obsessed with death.
Because of that, the Daystar approaches, and every day it grows brighter. This planet's final trial is coming.
All these light eco crystals and dark eco crystals are vital to this planet's survival. Right now, it seems that Jack is just trying to live for himself and keep himself in danger, but later on in the game he's going to fight to save the entire world, not just himself.
Looking for a bit of action? The scope shows a group of metalheads moving through the desert not too far from here. I don't like metalheads almost as much as I don't like you. And you've got some proving to do. Intercept those bad boys and give them hell. Who knows? You might even get a few toys for your effort.
Why does it sound like you're leaving out the dangerous parts? Jack, I'm getting some nasty juju vibes here. I don't have these whiskers for nothing, you know.
Relax. We could handle a few metalheads.
Have you ever seen a wasteland metalhead?
No. Why?
Nothing. Just wondering.
Go get 'em, heroes.
I hate these wastelander metalheads. They take forever to kill. I'm gonna speed up a lot of parts because it takes me forever. Now you have to try and find a pattern. I'm too lazy to find a pattern, so I guess that's why it takes me a lot longer than it should. Probably should try to figure something out, but I don't. That was kind of dumb the way I just crashed right into it. I just don't really care. Oh wow. Getting caught in between these two. Yeah, this is gonna take a while. You see, they can take so many hits. I would prefer if maybe there were 10 wastelander metalheads and it took maybe 1/5 as long to kill each and every one of them. It wouldn't be as boring. Okay, I died once. Okay, just one more. Get knocked around like hell on this one. This one is actually the strongest. Gee, look at all that purple. How many shots can it take? Okay. The hell? Look at that, this is ridiculous. How many shots can that stupid thing take? Okay, he's almost dead, I'm sure of this. That arrow might have something to do with the metalhead and KG death bot attacks on Haven City. Maybe he is the one behind the end of the world. Okay, there's a precursor orb tucked in here, yes.
Mr. Sand King, yes, I'd like to place a complaint. We've been training hard. My feet are killing me, and I think I'm getting a hangnail. So maybe I'll just...
This is the first attachment we get in Jack 3, the Wave Concussor. You hold down the fire button, you charge up the Wave Concussor, and you release the fire button to unleash a blast wave. Gonna collect some warp or cursor warps around this area. Nothing in here. What's wrong? I think I have to hold it down all the way. Yeah, that's right. Just hold down the Wave Concussor and unleash the biggest blast possible. And the Wave Concussor is actually difficult to use, so I'm just gonna use the Blaster mod. I'm gonna use that Wasteland move where I jump into the air, spin, and shoot. It's the best way to move through this arena mission.
just like that. Probably had a way easier time doing this arena mission than the first arena mission we do in Jack 3, when I just had my fists and the Dark Jack ability. This was pretty easy, I just sweeped right through it.
I can't believe you two are still alive!
Yeah, what a surprise.
Damas and I are very impressed.
Hey, Featherbutt, who appointed you king?
He did. Well, almost. Kind of a semi-king. You know, you should see our sleeping quarters and his harem of lovebirds. I never get any sleep these days. It's good to be the king, no?
I don't see no crown on that fat featherhead.
You want a crown? I'll crown you. Don't make me come down there from this perch.
I got a perch for you, birdie, right here. Twirl it.
That's it. It's go time.
Bring it on, bird brain.
Enough. If I wanted you to fight, I would have commanded it. You did very well, Jack. You make me proud that our training program is so good. Here is your second battle amulet and a new weapon mod. One more arena win, and you will be a true wastelander.
This is the second attachment, the beam reflector. This is probably the best attachment slash gun in Jack 3. If you do the Wastelander move where you jump, spin, and shoot, you'll probably annihilate like everything in sight. Oh damn, I forgot. I have to get off the leaper before I can enter.
Damas has a job for us, but I'm no babysitter, so stay out of my way.
Jack's not afraid of you!
Are you, Jack?
If you knew what was happening out here, you'd be afraid, all right.
What's going on here?
Nothing, your lordship. Just offering Jack and the little one here some healthy advice.
You have a reputation for being rash. Didn't your father ever tell you to pick your battles wisely?
I didn't know my father.
My point is, sometimes you face your enemy head on, and sometimes you wait until his weakness is revealed. Patience is a warrior's greatest weapon. Do you understand? Jack, I want you and Kleiver to go into the desert and herd a group of lizards into a waiting transport. We must prepare for whatever lies ahead. I need all the resources we can gather.
No problem. I'm good with animals.
I'll see you out there. Ciao.
Jack is wondering whether or not Kleiver likes him or not. Maybe he just likes to mess with him, he's thinking. Or he's being a prick to them. So here we are. Those are the blaster. Those are the jet boosts you can get from killing the Marauders. This is the Sand Shark, the first armed dune buggy. Daxter's gotta do this mission. He's gotta be the one who's gonna drive all the little leaper lizards into the pen. Jack just has to get close to one of them, and then Daxter will
hop right onto one of those little buggers. Come on.
I think this one's bad.
I have to admit, you got some talent, kid. Have another one of me vehicles. You earned it.
Damn straight! Would it be too much to ask for a foot rub? Nope, didn't think so.
At this point on, we're gonna have to purchase dune buggies with precursor orbs. These are the only dune buggies we're gonna get for free. All the other dune buggies going to have to be purchased with orbs. Now we're off to the monk's temple. We're gonna need this dune buggy. Every time we go to the monk's temple, we're gonna have to bring the dune hopper along with us to get there.
Three precursor orbs at the gate to the monk's temple. We gotta use this dune hopper to get up there. Alright, damn, I missed. Let's try again.
interesting these old pots have. Blaster mod ammo.
Seem said they lost an expedition of monks on the volcano. I bet they built these gliders to reach the top.
Yeah, lost being the operative word. If they vanished, don't you think that was a sign? Hello?
Yeah, but you've got me. All we have to do is hit those accelerator rings and we're golden.
Oh no! See any feathers here? Looks like fur to me. No feathers, no flyer the axle. There's no way you're gonna get me on some precursor monk crap! Absolutely zippo chance! Forget it! Finito! Fat chance! Not gonna happen! Nope! Nuh-uh! Never! Jack!
That was an extremely stupid idea for the game developers to actually include the talk about accelerator rings being out in the air like that. What the hell are accelerator rings doing all the way out in the air? I didn't even see any accelerator rings in the cutscene. Why would they mention that in the cutscene? That's just so stupid. I mean, it's fine to put the accelerator rings in the mission so you'll know where to go, but it's just extremely stupid for the characters to actually talk about there being accelerator rings out in the air like that. Another big mistake by Naughty Dog. We'll be right back.
can't go back the way we came. Let's go check it out.
Right behind you, partner! Far behind you.
I'm gonna try to use the wave concussor. It's more easy to use the regular scatter gun, it seems. Maybe I just don't know how to use wave concussor. It's only useful if the enemy is like all around you. If they're right in front of you, it's probably better to just use a scatter gun. What are Crimson Guard crates doing down here?
Wait here, I'll be back.
In Jack 3, Daxter mainly does platformer stuff. In Jack 2, he does a lot of shooting. When Jack is riding in a vehicle and shoots, it's not him who's doing the shooting, it's Daxter who's doing the shooting. We're not gonna do a lot of riding and shooting in this game. There's gonna be a lot of on foot missions. Wow, look how powerful Daxter is, knocking these big metalheads out in one hit. Except this one.
Later, Jack. To do everything? You miss me?
I like how Daxter looks all surprised when he sees the rock is moving. Doesn't make any sense. He was trying to get the rock moving. So why is he surprised when he moves? Jack is focused on aggression and attacks. Light Jack is focused on healing and defense.
Looks like I didn't agree with him.
Don't touch it, Daxter. Who knows what more dark ego would do to you?
Look at me, Jack. I'm short, I'm hairy, and I itch in strange places. I couldn't do worse. Relax. I know what I'm doing. Oh, yuck! Cold, clammy, dead hands. Oh, I can't look.
Look out, Daxter!
It's a dark power, Dax. Some kind of invisibility.
Yeah, well, cut it out! If you moved that fast a long time ago, I'd still be wearing pants. You know what I really miss? Soft underpants. You know how it lifts and cradles? You wouldn't understand. We're out of here.
Now we have the ability of invisibility.